In this video, I'm going to show you how to go ahead and add your overlays into Ecamm to make your stream look professional. So the first thing we're going to want to do is add our scenes for our live stream. So we're going to hit this little plus icon. We're going to name the first one starting soon. Hit enter. We're going to add another one. Second one is going to be countdown timer. Hit enter again. The next one we're going to go ahead and create is going to be our be right back. We'll do the same thing again here. We're going to create here our stream ending, and then we'll go ahead and create here our just chatting scene, and then we'll create our gameplay scene here as well. So now that we have all of our scenes created, we now want to go ahead and begin adding in our overlays. Now if you don't have any overlays, I'm going to go ahead and utilize overlays from streamdesigns.com, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. They have tons of overlays for you to be able to make your stream professional, from stinger transitions, countdown timer, sub badges, and they have tons of animated overlay packages for you to be able to choose from based on the game you play, based on your style. So for this example, I'm going to utilize the Zen Zone package, and you're going to see here that this is going to bring everything that I need from my starting soon, from my countdown, from my be right back, my stream offline. Now the countdown timer is sold separately in the packages, so you will have to add that additionally, and you can see here that I'll have that added here as well to be able to get the matching countdown timer, but you can choose any countdown timer that you want. Now if you got your overlays from Stream Designs, you're going to get a zip file. You're going to double click on that zip file, and you're going to create a folder for you to be able to see all your overlays. So once you go ahead and have your overlays, we're going to go ahead and come back here to Ecamm. And on Ecamm, what we're going to do is we're going to start with our starting soon. So we'll click our starting soon scene. And what you want to do is you want to come to source, hit blank, and you want it to be a black screen just like this. Now on overlays section here, and again, if you don't see the overlays tab, you can come here, click overlays, and this is going to pop up here for you. Make sure you select it on starting soon. And now we're going to go ahead and click this little plus icon. That's going to say animated overlays. This is going to bring us to the section where we've downloaded our Stream Designs files. Again, once you get the file, it's going to be a zip. You'll double click it and it will become a folder for you to be able to utilize just like this. And we're going to come to where it says overlay screens. We'll look for starting soon, hit open, add animated overlay. And now we can go ahead and make this bigger just by sizing it up. And now we need to click this little drop down option, and we want this to be able to loop. Then we'll come here to the right. We'll lock it and we'll make sure this stays in position. So now you're going to see here that we have our starting soon. The next thing we're going to do is add in our countdown timer. So we'll click on the countdown timer option. We'll come to sources, hit blank. We'll click this little animated icon again. We'll come here, go back. We'll select the countdown timer, 5 minute countdown timer. We'll hit open, add animated overlay. We'll go ahead and size it up again. Hit this little drop down icon. We don't want this to loop because we want, when the timer finishes, for it to just go to the next scene. And I'll talk about that later. Okay. So we'll hit that. We'll lock that there. Then we're going to come back to our be right back, hit source, hit blank. We'll then come here to sort of animated. We'll select the package. We'll go to overlay screens and you'll find the be right back option. So now we'll add that in there. Good to go. We'll lock it. And then we'll come here to our stream ending. Again, we'll hit source. We'll hit this little plus icon. We'll look for our stream ending, ending soon. We'll click here, add animated, make this bigger. We'll come here and we do want this to be able to loop. Then we want to lock it, and you want to make sure you do the same thing for your be right back screen as well. You want it to be able to loop. Then we'll lock that there. And now you're going to be able to see here, once I go ahead and get out of demo mode, you're going to be able to see here that now we have our starting soon. We now have our countdown timer. We now have our be right back screen. And now we have our stream ending scene as well. Now, the next thing that we want to be able to do is going to be our just chatting scene. This is going to be the scene where you're going to be able to be in intermission between games, or when you're just starting your stream, it's going to have your chat box. It's going to have your gameplay webcam, and it's also going to have you, your cam there as well, and then a few stream labels. So let me show you what that looks like here. So we'll hit this little here. We'll go to source. We'll hit a blank, just chatting with this little icon here. And then we'll look here at the just chatting scene. We'll hit open, and you'll see here, this is going to give us our window. We're going to want this to be able to loop. You'll see that we'll have our just chatting scene here as well. And what I want you to do now is I want you to go ahead and watch this video right here, where I walk you step-by-step on setting up the just chatting scene with your stream labels, your chat box, and your gameplay and webcam overlay as well. So click that video right there to learn how to do that next. I'll see you guys in the next video.